Look who the Alleghany Journal found. Wanda Simpson has been occupying the treasurer's office for years now. Well, hopefully we're going to find how many years. But recently, I think at least with us, it was last Friday, when she announced that she's going to be retiring as of June 30th, which just happens to be the end of the county's fiscal year. Welcome, Madam Treasurer.
Hello.
I think you found along the way many friends and supporters and even relatives, as well as the county administration. This has been an interesting job, a tough job, but I'm sure you have many memories. Tell us about a few of them.
I have a lot of memories. I started in Clifton Forge in 1981, and I have just had a glorious career in public service. I started with the Commonwealth Attorney's Office and worked my way up to Treasurer in Clifton Forge, and took a small hiatus when Clifton Forge reverted to a town in 2001, but found my way back through the help of a very good friend and colleague, Valerie Bruffy.
And many people may not know that you had worked with Bob Deaton, who half the county knew very well.
Bob Deaton was my mentor, and he came to me one day when I was working for Dave Davis and asked me, did I want one day to be treasurer? And sure, why not? And so I became his deputy, and then I became the treasurer of Clifton Forge, and Valerie Bruffy became my deputy. And then in 2005, I became her deputy. In 2011, I stepped into the shoes of Anna Fox and became the treasurer for Alleghany County. So it's been a long ride, and I'm ready to just go home and sit down and be a grandma.
I was going to say, I think there's grandbabies involved here
somewhere. There's one. If there was more, I would have left a while ago.
And Valerie, as you mentioned, is just down the hall here. So this is
we've worked so well together through the years as the commissioner and the treasurer. We've been through a lot, and she has been my right hand many, many times.
But of the challenges that a treasurer faces all along the way, is there any one that's more significant than another? I'm sure when you send people bills, there's going to be a certain percentage of them that are not going to be that excited about it. But is it the bill sending? Is it the bill collection? What's probably the most challenging part of your position?
The most challenging I would be collections, and that has changed so much through the years. It used to be you had to go through the courts for everything, but the General Assembly, they saw clear to change that, I can't remember the exact date, sometime in the 90s, and treasurers across the state of Virginia were given the opportunity to take your money a lot easier. So collections is probably the number one challenge that we have as a treasurer.
Well, you have a legendarily nice staff. I mean, I've never heard anybody say anything other than they're very pleasant. They still took my money, but they were very pleasant doing so.
My girls are the best. They really and truly are the very best. And I know that Teresa Brown, who's going to be the interim treasurer, is going to do a wonderful job during that six-month period between my leaving and the election. I chose to leave on June the 30th because that is the end of the county's fiscal year. And as a public servant, I am again trying to save your money. And instead of leaving in the middle of the year and having to have a closeout audit, it can all be done in one swoop at the end of the year, which is June the 30th.
Well, I don't know what your plans are on that particular day. I don't know what day of the week it is, but we certainly would appreciate the opportunity of roasting you. I mean, we can't let you just walk up.
What are you going?
So somehow we'll have to devise a roast or goodbye party. But what's going to be the number one thing you do when you don't step into this office?
Go hold my grandbaby. She's only 5 months old. She's new to me. I mean, she is just absolutely the best thing. And I can't imagine not spending my time with her. And that's probably 99% of the reason I'm leaving.
Wow, that's very sweet. Anybody that you'd like to give a shout out to before you walk out that door? I'm sure we won't have any problem roasting you, getting candidates to take the podium, but I think I certainly could speak for many of the county residents. We sincerely miss you. What is just a couple of months,
yeah,
and we'll have to say goodbye. So thank you for your service.
Well, thank you. I've enjoyed this beyond anything. I've enjoyed this. So thank you. But I suppose my shout out would be to those in Clifton Forge. It's my hometown. And as much as I love the people here and the county building, the people in the courthouse in Clifton Forge and City Hall back in the heyday were the greatest. I mean, there was Rusty Smith, there was Eleanor Downey, Kathleen Miller, Dorsey Huffman, and Duty Morse, my husband, and Valerie, and Gloria Topping, and Jenny Dunn, and Rhonda Elstock, and she's still there. Leanna Tyler.
Donna Nicely.
Right. Oh, I'd never forget Donna Nicely. Never. I was saving her for last. And the ones who've gone by, Aretha Saloya. These people, they molded me. They made me who I am. And I couldn't ask for a better outcome than the one I've had.
Lovely tribute. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.